And I would first of all acknowledge my two teachers, those who are present here, Mr. Abid Hassan Manto and Chaudhry Itadaz Hassan Sahib. Both of them have truly struggled for the enforcement of the fundamental and the human rights in the country. Thereafter, I acknowledge the Honorable Chief Justice of the Lahore High Court, Honorable Judges of the Lahore High Court and from other provinces, particularly my sister Lady Judges, because Aisha would complain that I didn't acknowledge her when I spoke about the brother judges. So sister judges, I acknowledge you too. All the distinguished guests at the podium, all those who have come to Pakistan from abroad, all those, the lovers of Asma Jahangir present over here, I am sure that physically she is not amongst us. But believe you me, I can feel her presence. I can't perceive her, but I can feel her presence by virtue of your presence, who are the lovers, the true lovers of Asma Jahangir. When I came to this hall or canopy, I read, I would not read the whole, I read, you knock, and 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 one day they are going to hear you. I wish, Apa Asma, you were here. Today the doors are open. There is no need for somebody to knock for sixth time. Kindly, if you were alive, would have come and seen what is going around the corner just in front of the post office building, the old State Bank building, where the people, even they don't have to knock, they just have to come and present their application. I'm not trying to aggrandize and project that we are doing great things for the people who are downtrodden, facing the miseries, oppressed class. But one thing I must remind you all, that the doors of justice now which you conceived should be the idealism of this country are open 7/24. I took up a slow motor notice when some friend of mine had sent me a video in which certain teachers had been handcuffed and brought to the NAB court for their remand. Sir, teachers are the most respected part of the society. They must be respected, honored, acknowledged. And even if they have committed some mistake, that should be taken to be in a lightest spirit and with the lightest kind of disrespect being shown to them. I read somewhere, and I mentioned this in my yesterday's discourse also, that Ishwaq Ahmed Sahab, a great intellectual of this country, he was in Germany, a professor there, teacher. He committed some traffic violation, but could not pay the challan or the fine within the requisite period. Therefore, he had to go to the court. The judge asked, "What do you do?" And he said, "I am a professor." The lady judge stood up and said, "You need not pay the fine. This is the respect which a teacher requires in the society." When Milan was conquered by Napoleon, he gave an amnesty that anybody who can take a refuge in the house of a teacher would be given or be let free. This is the respect of a teacher. Our Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when there were certain wars and people captured, unequivocally vowed that whosoever would teach the Muslims, he would be set free. This is the respect of the teacher. And Asma Jahangir was a teacher, a teacher, a teacher. Why do I say so? I have learned from him, from her. And what have I learned from her? What is the importance of the human rights? What is the significance of the fundamental rights? These are not meant for the purposes of decoration in a constitution or a legal instrument. These are meant for the purposes of enforcement, and this is what the constitution mandates, and this is the command of the constitution, and this is the requirement of the time of today. What I have learned from him, or from her, is the courage. Remarkable, unmatchable. I could not even conceive or think about a lady having such a courage and passion for the purposes of the enforcement, implementation, and raising voice for the human rights and the fundamental rights. Please, anybody in this house, can count me one lady, one single lady, who had been so passionate and so courageous for the purposes of the enforcement of the fundamental rights and the security protection of democracy in this country, for the constitutionalism in this country. I'm sure that none has raised the hand, and therefore she was absolutely, absolutely unmatchable. She was frail like me. I'm not very strong structurally, I'm not too physically, but I tell you, she was indomitable lady. She was a bulwark. Wherever there was a violation, starting with the feminist issues and then moving on to the security of the fundamental right, wherever there was issue, I would not see that Asma Jahangir was not present. It's a great day for us that she has left us a legacy. She has given a thought. She has provided us with the courage, the impetus, and that is what we have to acknowledge, and that is what we have to now perform. She has shown us the way, she has shown us the path. It is for us now to keep up what she has taught us, and this is how we have to come forward for the purposes of alleviating the miseries of the oppressed, marginalized people of the society, the downtrodden, for whom she had always been present and on the forefront. This is our duty. She has left this legacy and has also imposed upon us a duty to come out and to help the people, the oppressed people of the country. Ladies and gentlemen, let me share with you that the first suo motu action which I took after becoming the Chief Justice, I'm sharing that with you. I took oath on 31st of December. That was Saturday. And the next day was Friday. I got up at about maybe around 9:30. And there was a message from her, I want to speak to you. I thought perhaps she might be calling me for congratulating. But she said, do you know what has happened to Taiba? The girl who had worked at home and she was beaten brutally. And I said, yes, Appa, I do. I always used to call her Asma Appa. I said, Asma Appa, yes, I have come across that. I am filing a petition for that. And you have to fix it day after or tomorrow, maybe so. I said, okay. I thought about it, I pondered. If she would be filing a petition, why as a Chief Justice of Pakistan, I should not initiate the action for the securement of a fundamental right of a poor little child who has been misabused, who has been brutally beaten, and that is the start of my this passion, or the start which sometimes is being criticized also by my teacher, Itzaz Hassan, going too broad, but this is the beginning of my slow motor actions at Sasa. And she had encouraged me, and she is in a way the teacher in this regard also, but rather she is the initiator of the slow motor actions for the purposes of securing the fundamental rights. I would not say just for the purposes of decorating myself and the purposes of aggrandizing myself, but there is a witness to that. SM Zafar sir, he calls me up, says there is a serious threat to democracy. I asked, sir, what is the basis? There was no basis for that, but he said this is my inside information. I spoke to Asma. Asma Bibi, this is something I've learned from some very eminent and very authentic source. What should we do? And Asma told me, when are you going to give some speech, or when is a case fixed before you in which you can bring it the question of democracy? I think the first was the one which I addressed in Awari, and I made a speech that there would be no other form of government in Pakistan except democracy, democracy, and democracy. We cannot allow any system in this country, and this was a loud and clear message given to all those who could be. I'm not saying that it was an authentic information passed on to me, but it was a clear message given, no question of deviating from the constitution. Why? Because democracy isn't inevitably, democracy is imperatively, democracy mandatorily is the security for the fundamental rights of a citizen in a country. If there is no fundament, no democracy, there is no question about the enforcement or even the availability of the fundamental rights. And kindly look at the world around, then in which countries the fundamental rights and the human rights are primordially taken as sacred and are enforced, and the countries where there is none. So it is primarily the foundational and the basic feature of our constitution, which besides the Islamic purview of our constitution, I rate that the democracy is the basic structure of the constitution. And dependent upon the democracy are the fundamental rights of the people of this country, for which Asma Jahangir throughout has been striving. Without any consideration, she has a passion for that. I think this was genetically inbuilt, instilled in Asma Jahangir, that she had to help somebody who was in pain, somebody who was in misery, particularly starting on from the ladies' rights to protection, maintenance, blah, 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 blah. But ultimately, she turned out to be one of the finest human rights activists. The interpretation of law made by her in this context, and some of the cases argued before my humble bench, I tell you, amazingly high quality. And this all, I believe, was dependent upon the knowledge, but the passion behind it was amazing. The passion and the force behind it was unmatchable. Asma was known to me since 1980. We are contemporaries. She must be about 2 years older to me. And I met him in the court. And why did we develop this relationship of brother and sister? She was vomiting in the court. And not too well. I think Ramiza was coming to the world that time. And I took her to the hospital. There was a hospital, Uber hospital, where I took her. And I do recall not only other physicians, but the surgeon, Dr. Essensa, was also present. He did look up, but he was having pain in the abdomen and vomiting. Maybe it was something to do with a food poisoning. But that is a day I called her Aapa. And the first question she asked me, "Oh, main tere to addi vaddi hai, tu main Aapa kehna shuru kar deta." So I told her that who I respect out the ladies, I call them an Aapa. I call you, Ramize, also as an Aapa. This because it's a gesture of respect for my daughter, the respect for whom I really love and respect. Then my second interaction with her was, we have been meeting in the courts in so many cases. The second interaction was when he came to my office and said, ਔਰ ਮੇਰੇ ਕੋਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ ਸਮਝ ਆਉਂਦੀ ਬੈਂਗੋਰ ਵਟ ਹੈਪਨ ਵਟਸ ਦੀ ਇਸ਼ੂ ਭਈ ਕੋਈ ਲਾਹੌਰ ਗ੍ਰਾਮਰ ਵਾਲੇ ਕੋਲ ਕੋਈ ਇਸ਼ੂ ਹੈ ਦੈਟ ਇਜ਼ ਪਰਟੇਨਿੰਗ ਟੂ ਅ ਰੈਂਟ ਕੇਸ ਦੀ ਕੇਸ ਇਜ਼ ਫਿਕਸਡ ਫੋਰ ਹੋਰ ਸਰਸਸ ਅ ਜੱਜ ਵਟ ਆ ਡਿਫਿਕਲਟ ਜੱਜ ਹੈ ਗੱਲ ਹੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਸੁਣਦਾ ਤੋ ਆਈ ਵਾਂਟ ਯੂ ਟੂ ਡੂ ਦੈਟ ਕੇਸ ਸਿੰਸ ਦੈਟ ਡੇ ਆਈ ਹੈਵ ਬੀਨ ਦੀ ਰਿਟੇਨਰ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਲਾਹੌਰ ਗ੍ਰਾਮਰ ਸਕੂਲ ਵਿਚ ਹੀ ਯੂਜ਼ ਟੂ be the retainer of that Lahore Grammar, she passed on that to me. Then another incident, the closeness which I would like to tell. I believe Tahir Jahangir Sahib is here somewhere. Tahir Sahib, you are there. Tahir Sahib had some company issue, do you remember? You had a company issue, some company matter. And Asma Appa came to me, Saqib, I kisi horu nahi dena, eh tu karna. And till I was elevated, I think the matter had been on, but I didn't lose your case, sir. That is a respect and honor I think I have for Asma Ji. She was an amazing lady, unremarkable. And she, as I've already spoken about, that was a true teacher. Without her, we would not have been able to achieve the criteria, the standards, and the development of our jurisprudence which we have developed over the period in human rights security. A gentleman from India who spoke, I don't know his good name, but some lawyer, he said that Pakistan is far ahead of the Indians as far as the human right is concerned. Yes, we are far ahead. Why? Because perhaps there is none like Asma Jahangir, those who could fight for the human right of the people of Pakistan. Sir, she has always been there. She has always shown her love for this country. She has worked so hard for any downtrodden section of the society without any consideration, without any remuneration. And I feel very proud that Asma was my Appa. I am humbled that she has been my teacher, and also that today, present, what legacy she has left for us. It is the duty imposed upon each of us sitting in this hall, wherever the need be, to come forth and to help the people, those who cannot help themselves and are the oppressed and the marginalized class of this society. Long live Asma Appa. Long live Asma Appa. Long live Asma Appa.